Hi, Bethel Church. Hi, family and friends. Thanks so much for tuning in to our daily hope devotional. Today, I just wanted to share with you something that the Lord's been putting on my heart, and that is waiting well. I don't know about you, but I am not, a very patient person. I like things quickly. I like things the way I expect them to be. I like things in control. Like, I like being in control. And so I find myself not waiting well all the time. And for example, Amazon packages. I love Amazon. Free 2-day shipping with Amazon Prime, which I use quite often. But I also find myself tracking those packages a lot, where I'll be on my phone and I'm searching for the tracking number. I'm seeing if it's out for delivery, if it's been shipped yet or not. For me, it's a control issue, and I realize that I just don't wait well, because when that package gets lost or doesn't get delivered, I get worried, I get anxious, I get frustrated. And the Lord really challenged me that in this season of life that we're in sheltering at home, that, you know, our life is kind of like an Amazon package. Picture God as Amazon. He's Amazon manufacturer, and He knows when our package is going to be delivered, when the package being us, when we get delivered to our destination, which is the place after all of this is over. Only He knows when we're going to be there. And we're just kind of along for the ride. But while we're here, God told me that I have a choice in my waiting. I have a choice to wait with anxiety and fear and doubt, worrying every single day about what's going to happen next, what's going to change, what is the news going to tell me. Or I can wait well by putting my trust and my time and my dedication into my relationship with the Lord. And I felt really convicted by that. And I just want to share with you some thoughts that I had about that this morning, or today, excuse me. And I had a really good example of what waiting well looked like in my life. My mom and stepdad, a couple years back, they took their hand at being athletes. They tried their hand at being athletes, and what that looked like was bodybuilding. So my stepdad became a bodybuilder and my mom became a figure athlete. And it was a really cool process to watch, because they had always, you know, eaten healthy and worked out and exercised well. But I'd never seen anybody go from, you know, make this huge transformation in the matter of months and a year to becoming this crazy athlete in bodybuilding and a figure athlete. And it was cool to watch their daily lives change. And it impacted us as a family. We were all living at home at the time, me and my siblings. And so it changed a lot of things. And a couple of things I noticed is that their time changed. The time that they spent, you know, watching TV and watching movies for entertainment really changed. And they started watching bodybuilding competitions and workout routines and cooking shows and how to cook better, more lean foods. And the time that they were investing in this and in the gym and working out, and it was a lot of time at the gym, the time that they were investing was just a ton. And it really showed me, wow, they took every moment they could to really seek their goals and to get to the place that they wanted to get the results that they wanted to. The second thing I noticed about my parents is that they were dedicated. They were dedicated. They knew that, hey, you know what? I want to see these results. I believe I can get there. I know the steps I need to take to get there. And they stayed dedicated to their eating program, to their workout routine. They dedicated every single day and night to getting the results that they wanted to get. And, you know, the last thing that they really showed me was their trust. They had a ton of trust in their trainers. They'd never done this before, but their trainers had. Their trainers are actually, that's what they do, is they train people to become bodybuilders and figure athletes. And so their trainers knew what they were doing. And my parents had complete trust in their trainers. And even when things wouldn't go according to plan and they were missing goals or not quite hitting the mark, they still trusted in their trainers. And that showed me a lot. And I don't know about you, but that kind of feels like our waiting process right now. And I felt like the Lord spoke to me three things to wait well during this season of sheltering at home. And the first thing to waiting well is that we need to just think about and don't waste our time. Don't waste our time. Now, some of you might be thinking, what time? I don't have enough time in my day. I'm trying to homeschool my child. I'm trying to cook and clean the house while people are living in the house, and this is crazy, and I still have to work and do all of these things. Where is the time? And maybe on the flip side of that, maybe you're saying, I can't get off my computer or my phone because work is just taking over my life. Now I'm working remotely, working from home. It's really changing things, and I get that. But I believe that the Lord has given us this time to really pursue what He wants to do in us and through us. And I love Ecclesiastes 3, where it talks about the seasons of life. And Ecclesiastes 3, verse 1 says, "For everything there is a season, a time for every activity under heaven." That means that there's a time that we're in a season, we're in this time, and God wants to do something in it. Now, I don't know what He wants to do in your life. I know what He's doing in my life. But I want to encourage you today, don't waste your time. Stop what you're doing. Push pause on this video. Go sit down, close your laptop, turn your phone off, and just seek the Lord and say, God, what do you want to do in me and through me in this season? Because our prayers don't fall on deaf ears. God hears us. He answers us. And so step one step one to waiting well is don't waste your time. Don't waste your time. Number two is don't have wavering dedication. Don't have wavering dedication. So pretty much what I'm saying is that we need unshakable dedication to the Lord. Now is not the time to let our faith waver. Right now is the moment where we need to put our feet firmly on the foundation that the Lord has set for us. We need to be holding on to His promises and believing that His word is true, it's alive, and it's working in our lives. Our God is a God of promises. He doesn't lie to us, He doesn't keep things from us, but He has good things for us, and we need to hold on to those truths today. So we don't have time to waste. And number two, we need to have a huge dedication in the Lord, in His word and His promises for our life. I love what James 1, 5 through 8 says. It talks about wisdom. It says, if you need wisdom, ask our generous God and He'll give it to you. He's not going to rebuke you for asking. Verse 6, but when you ask Him, be sure that your faith is in God alone. Do not waver. For a person with divided loyalty is as unsettled as a wave of the sea that is blown and tossed by the wind. Wowza. I don't know about you, but I don't want to be unwavering. Let's firmly plant our feet in the promises that God has for us today. It's our responsibility. Jesus showed us His dedication by dying on the cross for all of our sins. God dedicated this relationship to us by making it accessible and free for all of us. It's our responsibility to reciprocate that and to meet God exactly where He's at. He's waiting for us. So today, have dedicated faith in the Lord. Let's put some action to our faith. Let's put some works to our faith. Say, God, yeah, I'm going to trust You today. I'm going to put my faith in You today because I know You're going to keep Your promises. So to wait well, don't waste your time. Have unshakable faith. And the third thing to waiting well is I want you just to ask yourself, where's your trust? I know for me, when I'm in control, I'm not trusting God. When I have the control, I don't trust God enough. Because if I trusted God enough, I would say, God, You have control. I give You my life. I give You the outcome of my situation. I give You the outcome of this coronavirus. I'm trusting that You're going to do with it what You want to in Your time. But I also know that I can lie to myself. I know how to lie to myself. I can't lie in general. Like, I'm a really bad liar. Try playing a game with me. I can't lie. I can't fib. It's so hard for me to do. But I know my weaknesses and I know how to lie to myself. So there's times in my life where I say, yeah, God, I'm going to give You control. I fully trust You. I'm giving You reins and I'm giving You everything. But in the back of my mind, there's this little tiny seed that's taking root of fear and doubt and worry. And today I want to encourage you just to get rid of all of it. Give God all of your trust because He's going to take our life and He's going to deliver the promises that He has for us. He's the author and finisher of our faith. He's going to deliver us in the right time. He's going to lift the shelter and home at exactly the right moment. You know, wherever your trust is, please don't put it in this uncertainty of a fallen world or the media. Let's put it, our trust and our hope in our one true King, the King of all kings. So today, I just want to encourage you to wait well. You know, we're in a season of waiting. Let's wait well. Let's not waste our time. Let's be dedicated to the Lord. Let's be dedicated to our faith. And the last thing is just let's trust Him. Let's trust that God has good things for us, that He's still our strong tower. The Holy Spirit is with us, guiding us in our steps. And we just need to believe and hold on to the truths and promises of His Word, because His Word is alive and living and moving in our lives. So I hope you stay encouraged today. Thank you again for tuning into our Daily Hope. Be blessed, friends.